I am so bored. There's literally nothing to do. Guess I could find a game to play. Yeah, I guess I could check that out. Seen that. Did that. Never in a lifetime. Oh, what's this? Blood for the Blood God, a dating sim demo. Well, that seems kind of interesting. Let me see. Warning, explicit language. Blood for the Blood God is a dating sim in development. Here's the official demo, which will allow you to become more familiar with the four bachelors who are available to be romanced or killed. Oh wow, and the art's really gorgeous. You know what? I might just check this out. Alright, let's see what this is about. I forgot to do the thing. I don't want to do that, please. Please. Text speed? Yes. Why do nobody go to full text speed? Alright. A strong, deep voice calls for you. What name does it call? It obviously calls the name... Penny. That's right, it calls for Penny. It's dark and warm, you feel yourself listlessly You feel yourself listlessly float along an unseen current. Penny, that is the most anticlimactic name. You hear a commanding voice call out to you, deep and commanding. You hear a voice calling out to you, deep and commanding. A shiver runs through your spine. Is that what it is? Have you always had it? The voice calls again. Penny, through my blood you were born. Let the life which flows through me be given to you. Let the beautiful red take form and become solid. Let it birth and... A servant who will carry out my will. I call you forth once again, Penny. That is such an anticlimactic name. You feel your body rush forward to the surface with such force that you gasp, and for the first time, the sweet piercing air hits your throat. Everything about you is so heavy and clumsy, like a dying fish, you gasp and flail. Then the once calm current is abandoned, and you are thrust into what can only be certain madness. It's awful. Who would dare pull you from that comforting darkness? You open your eyes. Hot damn! I just knew this would be my kind of game. What's up with the music? Is that copyrighted? A man stands before you. He's probably the hottest guy you've ever seen. I mean, he's still the only guy you've ever seen, but you're still sure he's the hottest. Is he blinking with all three eyes? Oh my god, he is. He stands in a pool of red liquid, blood. Yes, that's right, it's blood. He stands up to his thighs in deep red. His six eyes stare down at you. Suddenly you're quite aware of how insignificant you are, how small you are in comparison to this confident and commanding man. Slowly you bow to him before... For that is what his fierceness demands. A smile spreads across his face, blood oozing out from the corners of his mouth. Charming. I didn't expect my next emissary to be so, what is the word, underwhelming, but I suppose you shall have to do. Not everyone can be like Scaff, after all. He smiles again. What a lovely smile. With blood oozing out from his fucking mouth. Your heart beats just a little faster. What a strange sensation. The man walks up to you, his movements so fluid and controlled that the blood barely ripples. His fine robes drag you through the vicious fluid, staining the white a brilliant red. I am your lord and master, your end and your beginning. I am the Blood God. This music does not fit the Blood God at all. Holy shit. The Blood God sounds nifty. You raise your head a little, trying to get a better glimpse at his bare chest. Raw! Listen closely. I am a serious Let's Player. I do serious games. Listen closely, my servant. I have a task for you. He had a grim look on his face with all six eyes fixed on you, the weight of it enormous. You lower your head once more. You need to find three of my former servants. These traitors fled to another realm, defying my orders and refusing to bring me blood sacrifices. Go, find them, bring back their blood. This is the task I bequeath you, Penny. Penny. Of course, we're like the most underwhelming servant of this like almighty blood god called, when we're called Penny. Okay, seems pretty simple, except for a lot of things, but whatever you say, blood god. Best to clarify a few things. Wow, we're not that underwhelming, we look pretty cool. If I bring back that blood, you mean? A smile spreads across the blood god's face. It would be nice. It would maybe be angelic if it wasn't for the sheer malice in his voice and the fact that he's oozing blood from his mouth and eyes. Kill them. If you are able to end their lives, they will turn into blood and return to me. They've been separated from me for far too long. He frowns, observing the blood around his thighs. My power has dwindled, but I put too much of myself into them. But to live and learn. I am correcting the mistake now, you on the other hand. He walks forward, runs a finger carefully across your cheek, leaving a thin trail of blood. Serious, compelling gameplay. Ducky, ducky. You are the perfect creation, strong enough certainly to bring them down, but your mind. The blood gap gives your forehead an affectionate flick, laughing softly as it watches the confusion on your face. Your mind is not so complicated. You are loyal to me and me alone, the perfect servant. You should feel honored. It took a great deal of time, effort, and love to put you together, my dear Penny. And then he calls her Penny. Oh, wait. It feels a little like he's making fun of you, but then again, you were literally born 3 minutes ago. Maybe this is normal. You try to ponder the idea more, but your thoughts slip through your fingers like the wet liquid you stand in. Ah, it matters not. This is your master, after all. Who are you to betray him? Who are you? Penny. The authority in his voice pulls you from your thoughts. You focus on him once more. Do you understand your task? Will you carry out my bidding and bring back the blood of those who have forsaken me? Yes, my lord. The blood god looks pleased. He smiles at you once more. Smart child. He raises his hand and quickly sketches out a complex sign that your eyes can barely follow. The blood that had been laced that have been so lazily circling suddenly jolts to life in great streams. It rises above the god's head and forms what looks like a swirling portal. I'm sorry, I'm just like, this is like very descriptive what's happening, which is very like prettily written, like very decently written, and the art style is so gorgeous, and I just love the inner thoughts of the fucking main character. Like, god damn it. The vibrant reds are almost hypnotic, they mix and separate in an endless dance. He's turned back to you now. This shall take you to the other world. There you will locate my three former servants. You shall know when you see them, for the blood within you, my blood, will alert you to their presence. Now go. You rise to your feet, wobbling slightly at first, before regaining your footing. What a strange feeling movement is. I know. It's mighty strange. Lugging this heavy body with you is a constant battle with gravity, but the blood god's order is absolute, you must go. The blood god stops you in front of the swirling blood vortex. He gently takes your face between his hands and leans in close, so close you can see the six pupils of his eyes. What a beautiful shade of red his eyes are. Ah. Remember now, dearest Penny, if you ever betray me, that is, if that thought ever somehow makes it into that empty little head of yours, I will not hesitate to turn you back into blood. Is that clear? There is a lump in your throat that cannot be swallowed. Instead, you manage to stiffly nod your head. Good child. He gives your forehead a quick, almost warm peck. The next instant, you feel yourself lifted from their feet, and the vortex quickly sucks you into its gaping maw. For what it feels like ages, you tumble through the red beast, up, down, left, right, clockwise, counterclockwise, then a bit to the left again. And finally, with a thud that surely would have cracked a normal human skull, you land in the middle of the darkened street. It appears to be night. The cold moon hangs in the sky, watching as you You, the new arrival, the newest arrival, stumble to your feet. What fateful encounters will you have under this blackened starry sky? Go to the dump, go home, go to the cafe, or go to the pet store. I kind of want to just go to the pet store for shits and giggles. You turn the corner and see a man standing about halfway away from you. Not you. I don't want you. I have standards. You choose to go to the cafe. There's a rumbling in your stomach that you don't understand when you see the place and you feel going. Buildings. You don't have to go far, since it's my a wide selection of. Give me a sec. How do I. Oh, I can't remember. Damn it. Right click? No. Never mind. Okay. Oh. There we go. A wide selection of butlers. Huh. You don't have to go far to get a cafe. It just said that. Oh, man. What is a butler? You have no clue, but the first part of the word makes you hopeful. We look so cute, though. Like, we're really adorable. You walk a man in a black suit, holds up a gloved hand. I'm skipping. I shouldn't. I don't want- Oh, yeah, that's right. I don't want that guy. Go back where you came from. I don't want the cafe, then. I'm looking for one of the guys, the black-haired dude. Go to the dump? You decide to go to the dump, Lord knows why. You walk through the town, past acute little buildings with darkened window, past the water fountain, which now runs dry, and past the closed shops who still tempt you with brightly painted signs. The path leads you to the outskirts, where gentle light flickers on and off, clearly this part of town is not well maintained. A large fence looms before you, the top covered with barbed wire, a sign some feet away warns of electrocution. Certainly, trespassers are not allowed to be, but being a creature of blood, these things do not frighten you. Additionally, the gate to the junkyard is just wide open. Security sure is tight around here. Yep. Casually, you waltz into the enclosed area, admiring the scrap pieces which litter the yard. A sad-looking bicycle sits on one of the nearby piles. Out of curiosity, you ring the bell. Ring, ring. It's sad, echoes through the junkyard. Rest in peace, little bike. Another shiny object catches your eyes. Wonder what it could be? You're about to walk towards it when suddenly an unseen figure grabs you from behind. You struggle violently against him, but the grip only tightens around your arm. Pain. Ow. Yes, that's what this is. It hurts. Ow. 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 The figure spins you around and suddenly you're face to face with your attacker. Damn. The art style is really pretty. Well, hello there! I am ashamed to say that that was exactly what I was going to say. I am ashamed to be part of this species. The species called me human. Oh, maybe, like, I don't know if the artist actually made the drawings, the creator of the game made the drawings herself, but if, like, she did, then she can appreciate the beauty of her own drawings, and if she didn't, I feel like, when I've been working with artists, I just look at the art they make for for the game I'm working on, and I'm like, holy shit, I love this. So, yeah, I would be fangirling over it as well. Well, hello there. Damn, that's so pretty. God. The man that's gripping your arm has dark hair and piercing green eyes. Well, he's no blood god, but he's not bad looking either. You feel the pain lessen a little. However, he continues to hold you tightly, a suspicious look on his face. You feel the blood within you grow restless. It froze quickly. It writhes. Could this man be... Who are you, and what the fuck are you doing in my junkyard? I don't know why I'm swearing. This guy is just gonna be a swearer. His voice is quiet, yet demanding. This is... Oh, we're going fancy rocky in here. Well, this is his junkyard. You take a look around, noticing several cardboard boxes stacked into the shape of a house. Could he actually live in there? In the trash? Oh my god. Same. We can be trash together. How sad. You look at this man with something like pity in your eyes, he seems to have noticed. Hey, I will have you know that this is top quality real estate right fucking here. 5 acres of land all to myself, I don't even have to pay rent, it's away from all the fucking noise of the city. Besides, I would be caught dead in some pretty little suburb house. Oh, you have a white picket fence, a yard, 2.5 children, don't make me puke, that isn't fucking living. Oh my blood god, he's still talking. No, I don't want the kind of life that the media says I should live. No, no, not for me, not for Lucifin. His name is Lucifin, what, he's still fucking talking? You gotta get me out of that sheltered city life, live moment to moment, that's all that really, all that it really means to be alive. I can tell, you're just some lost soul, right? Lived for too long in that pampered lifestyle, come to learn from the master how to truly live, right? Lucifin grabs your arm, it's sore, but there's not even a sign of a bruise. Well, you're not even sure if you do bruise or whatever. Smiling at you with bright, excited eyes, Lucifine, demeanor has done a complete 180. So, my little chickadee, what would you like to learn first? Not the personality I envisioned. I don't dislike it. Perhaps you'd like how to collect rainwater? How to scavenge the most edible food from the fucking trash heaps? Or maybe you'd like to listen in the more intramarash, if you know what I mean. Leaning towards you with seductive eyes, Lucifin pulls you closer, his fingers tilting your chin up, forcing you to face him. My, where does this all come from? We'll assure you that a night with me is one you'll never forget. Well, if Undyne ever taught me anything, it's that you have to do the best and the most force. The fucking nerve of this man! Kill him! Kill him! Kill him! What happens if you do the others? Like, just... You lightly tap the chest with him! What the fuck? What does that mean? You just go here so I'm trying to put the moves on you? Feeling embarrassed and angry, you quickly jab him the right hook. Lucifin releases you and staggers back a few steps. You punch connected solidly with his stomach and the effects are clear. Doubled over, his legs shake, looking as though they'd give in any second now, but somehow he remains standing and regains his breath. A triumphant smile adorns his face and his eyes sparkle brightly. What in the- is he a fucking masochist? Wow, have you been trained? I've never felt a punch like that before. Amazing! I've really found something incredible. Hey, will you spar with me some more later? This man is suddenly bubbling with excitement, and the way he's looking at you as if you're the most exciting piece of junk in this yard. A warm feeling spreads in your chest that somehow becomes difficult to meet his gaze. I'm sorry, it's just... the romance. Oh man. Out of all the junk in this yard, you're definitely the most attractive junk. So why don't we go to my place and we can see what we can do with my junk. I'm the worst. I am the worst. It's not such a bad feeling though, having him look at you like this. No, it's not bad at all. Lucifin walks toward you unconsciously. You put up your fist again, he laughs and gently tussles your hair. Now this feels nice too. I know better than to mess with you. Sorry about that earlier. Thorns be a joke. Not the kind of person to do with that with someone I just met. He places his hand gently against the small of your back and begins to lead you to the carpet house. You notice a faint light shining from within. Huh, maybe it's roomier than it looks. I think you should stay with me for tonight. It's too cold to keep you wandering around. I only have one futon, so it's pretty large if I do say so myself. Plus, I have a spare blanket. It should keep you warm. Tomorrow, I'll introduce you to the boss. I'm sure he'll be pleased to have you on board, huh, partner? Lucifin casually places his arm around your shoulders, still simply ecstatic. He continues to chatter on happily. You welcome the warmth of his house, and feel yourself flush as he continues to compliment. Excuse me. But you could tell that he was holding back before. After all, when he first caught you, it was almost impossible to escape that grip. You're supposed to kill this man, right? But he's... But the Blood God must have underestimated him. He's far too strong to take on head to head. Somehow you have to catch him by surprise. These thoughts begin to fade, however, when he once again tussles your hair. Such a nice feeling. Well, the Blood God never did give you a time limit. Maybe joining up with this guy won't be such a bad idea. This way you can bide your time. Until he fully trusts you, and then... And then... And then what? Heartwarming ending. Thank you, Travis. Casey and she... She'll cry. I'm sorry, it's just... I don't know, it's... I wanna see what happens if I punch him, like, really hard. Give me a sec. We're Penny. Penny for life. Hot damn. What happens if we punch him, like, to the abyss? We're gonna go to the dump because that's where we always go. Puffing, you strike out Lucifer, fists flying. Oh shit, you fucking rugged him off the stratosphere! Oh my god, what the fuck? Wait! There you go! Into the space! Must have landed on the moon by now! Or maybe on the other side of town. You really don't know your strength. Unfortunately, you can say the sense that he's still alive. Or maybe it wouldn't be that easy to kill him making it from the Blood God, but damn it! I have to go track him down, and boy will he be looking for a fight. Some things this is more difficult. Nervously, you hold the arm he gripped so tightly earlier. Shit, this guy won't go down easy. Somehow, you need to jump on him. Not even no enemy, or well, no helping it now. Walking out of the junkyard, you analyze the trajectory of your punch and figure he must be back by the water fountain. Maybe if you're quick enough, you can catch him in a daze. You begin to sprint back to town. Mega Newton punch ending. Oh my god. And what that happens? He's not actually gonna, you know, take advantage of us if we just do that. Let's just tap his. Bleh. Let's see. I wanna see all options. Stop doing that tongue thing, it's overused. You lightly tap him on the chest with your fist, on uncertainty and anxiety. You're not used to such arousing actions after. Seeing this, as he immediately drops his hand to his side, off his teeth. I was just kidding. Okay, you're not that kind of guy. Good to know. Well, you can stay. It's pretty large. Okay, so it's fine. A gentleman. Sleep for now. In the morning, I'll. Okay, so it's the same. It's a neutral ending. Cool. Cool. Okay, now I wanna bang with the boss. Can I do that? Can I bang with the boss? I wanna bang with the boss. That'd be pretty cool. Why would you do that? Cause I wanna bang with the boss, that's why. Apparently, Penny cannot bang with the boss. Thank you, Travis. This is gonna get a bad ending, but I wanna. Oh god, fuck me. Crap. Well. Oh boy. That hurt like a bitch. Premature ending.
No! Thank you, Travis.
That's just gonna be a thing for me from now on, I think. It's just, I don't know why that stuck with me. Just, I don't know. We all know that Penny's a fucking moron. A ducky ducky fucking moron. I knew that was gonna be a bad ending, but I wanted to see what happened. Alright, let's go to the butler now. Yes, thank you.
He holds up a gloved hand and apologizes for the crowds in the cafe. He tells you there's only one possible seating area for you, and you take it, still not knowing what the hell a butler is served at a cafe. Well, that guy actually does look like one hell of a butler, if you get what I'm saying. Smart over teapots, yay. Cinnamon cream cake, twisted lemon pie, like, nice. And hello, valued customer. A man stands before you, white hair, startling contrast to his dark skin. His eyes gleam at you innocently, brightly. Oh my god, what a cutie. His suit is lighter than the others, but still warm and complements his sparkly features. For some reason, your mouths keep watering. Is this a butler? Hoopa hoopa! He's called Pizza, babe! And I thought Lucifer was funny! Oh my god! Pizza, babe! I can't take that! Oh my god! Kill me now! You can just call me Beetle. Oh, babe. I'll be taking care of you today. If you have any questions on the menu, please don't be afraid to ask me. He passes, a shadow falls over his face. There's also, oh no, I shouldn't say. You think that his fall is idle and is suspicious, and because the Blood God has sent you on the mission, your curiosity is essential, right? You're doing this for the Blood God, because he's most important. You ask what Beetle Babe wanted to say. Oh, it's just I was working in the kitchens early. I made a special dessert. I was trying to come up with something special for my next guest, but my cooking isn't that great. You look at his chocolate skin, pale eyes, and you wonder if his cooking tastes as good as he looks. Wow. You insist on trying the new dish. Not for you. For the Blood God. Obviously, you just need this to get on this good guy's good side. Probably. Beetle Babe leaves. Beetle Babe? I will never be able to take that seriously. Not that I can take this game that seriously in the booth. You wonder how you can be the first guest. My stupidly bright and attractive smile. The dessert. Ta-dum! This is my special white chocolate cheesecake with homemade chocolate caramel. Fuck, that sounds delicious. Like, it combines two things I love, cheesecake and white chocolate. You can't do this to me. Alright. You eat it, you take a bite, the taste in your mouth makes your body sore. It's a combination of rough and sweet, gushy and soft. The white cream is sensational, the chunks of white chocolate are a blessing against your throat. Then you suddenly taste it. Something bitter, harsh, something that coils in your chest like a snake. Poison. But it can't harm you. Beetle Babe stares at you, eyes wide and full of tears. So, it's okay, right? He asks hopefully. The poison runs through your stiff system and does nothing. You're a creature of blood, the Blood God's loyal servant. Your poison can't harm you. You stare up at Beetle Babe, who's on the verge of tears. Did he poison you on purpose? His eyes tell him a different story. Seductively finish eating the cake. Kind of wanna. So I can see there's one silly ending, one like heartwarming ending, and one neutral ending. And stab him with your fork! Holy shit, okay? I'm gonna seductively eat cake. An idea occurs to you as you watch the rest of the fake occupants. Many of the girls are giggling. Some of the butlers just laugh it off, while all are clearly flushed. Doing those things weaken them. Can you tell the flute? Maybe you can kill two flies with one stone. You heft yourself up on the table. Played on your knee. Poised elegantly in front of you, and then slowly continue eating the cake, letting your tongue linger purposely on the silver prongs. When you press your lips together, you let your tongue run over the creamy white of the cake settled on your lips, and manage what you think is a pretty good smile. You lazily bat your eyelashes. You are unsure of Beetle Babe's reaction, but you do know he seems very different. He's staring at you with wide eyes, a severe crimson tinting his cheek. He's also speaking, but his words are incoherent, and you realize he's stuttering. Finally, he speaks. What are you doing? He squeaks with a nervous laugh. For some reason, you find the blush in his dark face oddly alluring. You glance briefly to the side, noticing one of the butlers taking a woman's hand, so you take Beetle Babe's hand, looking at him seriously. Oh, gosh, he says.
He looks faint and a little too hard. He looks like he might fall over. You steady him and look into his eyes. For a few moments you don't say anything, and Beetle Babe doesn't say anything. Then he raises his hand and shouts laughs a little. A little shakily. There we go. Oh, I'm very sorry, I'm not very good at that. His face is still bright red, but it is, well, kind of cute. Cute? Yes, because he's not the same hot damn that a blood god is, clearly. Anyways, I'm glad you like my cake, dear customer. Treasured customer. He smiles again brightly. No one usually likes my food. I mean, they like it, but then there's taste that just happens I can't get rid of. Poison. He can't get rid of the taste of poison. What kind of man is he? He may be the most dangerous than, more dangerous than you thought. Was it an accident? Or was he testing you? He asks for your name and you give it. Beetle Babe smiles at you brightly. Penny, that's a beautiful name, much better than mine. I will say Beetle Babe is quite the amazing name. Anyways, if you stay here, I can get you some drinks, food, and the house. No, I insist. I'll pay. Think of it as a treat. He pauses again and try to explain your situation that you currently have nowhere to leave. A confident expression comes onto your face. You're just like me. The manager lets me live upstairs. If you're willing to work, anything for a friend? I hope you don't mind because you're calling your friend, Penny. Beetle Babe walks off with a skip in his step, even though he still looks a little dazed. He glances back at you, a little shyly, before disappearing somewhere in the back. You feel a little floaty on the inside, and you're pretty sure it's not the cake, the one that tasted poison, still on your tongue, giving you mixed feelings. But Beetle Babe looked, well, not very guilty of a crime. He looked innocent, and that gives you some kind of hope. But for what? Aren't you supposed to kill this guy? You sigh out a little as you take the rest of the dried cake. You pick up your fork and munch on some of the chocolate bits, deep in thought. Conflicted emotions ending. Thank you, Travis. Conflicted. I'm sorry. I am so tired. Jesus Christ. Oh my god. I think that's good. This is definitely worth it. I actually, the full game will be out in a very far away future as soon as I know. Maybe not, but I think next summer was mentioned or something. But if you're interested, I'll leave a link in the description for this little tiny demo thing. I don't really know what to say about this. It's like the good and the horrible are clashing, and I don't know what to believe in. I did have fun though, so I guess that's all that matters. Hope you had fun too. I will see you in whatever. Goodbye.
Fuck me.